Do you know where your food is coming from? Well, we are about to find out today with Mary Banford. She's a registered dietitian with Dietitians of Canada. And Mary, I think a lot of people now are really becoming health conscious and wanting to know where their food is coming from and what is involved before they start serving it to their families.
It's so true. People are so keen on where their food's coming from, and I think it's wonderful. Because when people start thinking about where it's coming from, they'll naturally make more wholesome, natural choices.
Right.
And so it's fantastic. So Dietitians of Canada, in support of this movement, wants to help Canadians continue to do that. So at our website, dietitians.ca, we have lots of information and activities to help people find farmers markets, to help people make recipes with homemade food, see what's in season. So we have lots of information there. But today, I brought you some fun information that we found out
through
to help people
survey,
learn,
right?
Through a recent survey, yes. So Dietitians of Canada surveyed Canadians to find out what their favorite local food was.
Okay, and?
There was a difference region to region, province to province, and interestingly and not surprisingly, it's specific to what their local friends and neighbors make.
Okay, so we're going to start off here.
Yes. BC, British Columbia, they just picked all vegetables.
Okay.
They went wild, all vegetables. And since we're bridging winter and spring, I put in some great winter vegetables that you can get at the supermarket, from the storage vegetables, like the root vegetables, like
this here. This is what?
Celeriac.
Okay, and what do you do with this?
So that's celery root. It is fabulous in soups and stews. It tastes like celery, but a little bit stronger flavor.
But Mary, I have to say, really, if you're looking at this, this is one ugly vegetable, but I bet it tastes fantastic.
I'll bet you could get a boy to chop that and make scary things with it and then be more interested in eating it.
So what do you do? Do you peel this? And
yes,
then
you peel it. So all the ugly roots, those come off.
Okay, so these come off.
Those come off. And I just chop that off. Take my cheese knife. I just chop that off and then I would cut it in half, or I'd peel it.
Okay.
And then dice it up and throw it in stews, throw it in soups. It adds just a lovely, subtle flavor.
And would this sort of be like, I guess I want to say like a sweet potato or a turnip, in the sense of that you need to dice it and cook it long enough so that...
It's actually got almost no calories in it, unlike a sweet potato. So it's virtually calorie free, but it's got a little bit of texture to it. So you can actually mash it with mashed potatoes and go half and half to make your mashed potatoes lighter.
Okay, I first came across this last year and was so excited. Cauliflower, because now you can get cauliflower not only in white, but you can get it in a bright orange color and even in purple.
Yes, and it's so hard to get those colors like purple and orange in our diet, especially with kids. There aren't that many choices. We need an orange and a dark green every day to get the nutrients we need. So carrots, of course, sweet potato, squash, but it's nice to have something else that's fun. And cauliflower is fantastic for that. We grow all the different colors here in the fall.
Right.
And you know, you talked about steaming it, but cauliflower is to me the perfect roasted vegetable.
Oh, I love roasting
a little bit of olive, a little bit of nutmeg.
Oh, nutmeg.
Yeah, and just roast it for 45 minutes at about 400 degrees, and it is pure candy at any temperature, fresh out of the oven or later for leftovers.
And again, because it's orange or it's purple, does that mean that kids are getting that extra like sugar, or they don't have to worry about that?
Carotenoids. You're getting extra nutrients. So the colors of vegetables represent some of the phytochemicals or the plant nutrients that are there. So that's your carotenoids. So they're very important.
Asparagus was part of BC as well?
All vegetables, so that's spring. So asparagus, radishes, beans, fiddleheads, rhubarb, that's coming. That season's coming. So it's like, okay, stews are ending, this is coming in. So it's exciting to think about asparagus season,
so
always.
Let's move on from BC, and where are we off to next?
Alberta. So guess which is Alberta.
I'm thinking it's the meat right here.
It's definitely beef. So
okay.
20% of Albertans for their favorite local food is absolutely beef.
Okay.
And that is an extra lean choice there, and that's four Canada's Food Guide servings. So each of those steaks is two Canada's Food Guide servings. So it's very reasonable to have one serving, which is half of that per day.
Okay.
And still have good health.
Okay. So beef was for Alberta.
Mm-hmm.
And next?
The Prairie Provinces. So they picked corn on the cob.
Okay.
So our cob is a bowl. because I couldn't get corn on the cob right now.
But we appreciate you trying, Mary.
Thank you. So they like fun food. Corn on the cob is a Prairie Province favorite. It's funny, we're one of the largest exporters of beautiful Durham pasta to the best pasta makers, but the Prairie Provinces like sweet corn.
I just say when you're using corn on the cob, make sure you have dental floss on hand to help people out afterwards, because that is so annoying when it's stuck in your teeth. Okay.
Super.
Do we want to talk about the lobster yet? Or?
Oh, save that one. He's scary.
Okay, we're going to save
him. He's scary. So moving on to Ontario.
Okay.
Have I got this in the right order? Yes.
Yes.
So Ontario, we're apples. We're pure and simple apples here in Ontario.
Really?
We are. We love our apples. So they are actually also, by weight, the biggest export we have.
Okay.
Yeah. So apples, and let's face it, an apple, it stores all winter long in the right atmosphere, but right off the tree, how can you deny an apple?
No, and it's always great too when you can do that right off the tree and eat it and know that there's nothing in it that you have to be afraid of.
Right, it's just tart, beautiful, crisp apple.
And you picked out a really nice apple there too.
I did.
Cheese?
Quebec. La Belle Provence loves their cheese. Canada produces over 665 varieties of cheese.
And this particular one here that we're looking at has got mushroom in it, right?
It is, and it's an oka cheese with some mushroom in it, so that would really go well with the beef and some asparagus in a salad.
Well, I'm just liking how you paired it with the strawberries.
Yes, because I'm thinking spring already, so spring strawberries.
Cheese, oh gosh, I love cheese. Okay. Fantastic. Mm-hmm. Now we're moving on to
the Maritime Provinces.
Yes.
So this is my very scary. The live lobster was a little dangerous.
Yes.
He escaped. He ran away. So we grabbed a picture of him after we boiled him up. So the Prairie Provinces love their lobster. And yeah, don't we all? It's a beautiful source. It's a bottom feeder animal. It's a healthy environmental choice. Lobsters are great in the fisheries right now, and they regulate it well across the Prairie Provinces for how they harvest them.
Okay.
So sustainable.
So really, province to province, this is what some of Canadians' favorite foods are.
Mm-hmm.
Now, speaking of food, we're going to continue on because you're going to make a salad for us here.
I sure am. It's nice to mix winter salads. It's that winter, almost summer, it's time for salads. And let's take some great root vegetables like beets.
I love this because the salad you're making here, you can have a spring. I would even serve this in the summertime.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. It's great. So last night's dinner, you ate the beet greens.
Okay.
And then you've got the beets. So this is just, it's about 2 cups of beets.
Okay.
2 to 3 cups of beets. It's not fussy. It's a salad.
And Mary, this is just plain beets right now, right? You haven't put anything
on it. I haven't done anything in it. So the recipe calls for roasted beets on the Dietitians of Canada website. I cheated. I use canned.
Okay.
And they're still good. You can be the taste tester.
But you can use either. It just depends on your lifestyle. If you're really busy and you don't have time, don't feel guilty. Do everything else the night before if you can, and then just go with the can if you have to.
The canned beets with no added sugar or salt are just as nutritious.
Okay.
Yes, they're good. So to add some color, we're going to add some grated carrot. So 1 cup of grated carrot. And then 1 cup of diced red cabbage.
Okay.
Sliced and diced. So, and then for some color, some lovely chopped
yes.
green onions. That's
Love
just a
that.
Half a cup. And it's every kitchen needs a good spill. And I'm going to add the dressing now. So the dressing is just a lovely vinaigrette with 1/4 cup of red wine vinegar.
Right.
2 tablespoons of canola oil.
Okay.
A teaspoon of either dry mustard or mustard. And there's one less thing, and 1 tablespoon of honey. Just that little bit of sweetness.
And again, the nice thing about this, it's all fresh. You know what you're putting in. You don't have to worry.
So simple. And then I didn't have any fresh dill, so just 1/2 teaspoon of dried dill will do the trick. And I'm going to toss that because there's a lot of color in beets, and I don't want it to get on the next thing. The garnish is, and the garnish is a beautiful
feta cheese. I love this.
Feta cheese.
Look at this. It's absolutely beautiful, and I bet it tastes wonderful. And again, this is great. Get the kids involved in the kitchen so that they know what they're preparing and introduce them to some of these vegetables.
And if they like neat, they can do the neat vegetables. They love messy, they can do those beets. They get the hands so red and scary. So for garnish, a little bit of feta cheese.
Okay.
So this is a nice Canadian feta cheese. And who doesn't love some toasted sunflower seeds?
Look at that.
And of course, this nothing has any added salt, so you can tell me whether it tastes fine without
yes.
any added salt.
But I'm going to start digging in while you do this right
in.
Now. This looks so good, Mary.
It really, and that was really easy.
Oh, that is so wonderful.
Isn't that easy?
I love the dressing, and I love the cheese.
Yes.
The little bit of a zing with the cheese. That's fantastic. And this recipe, is available on the website.
On the website, Dietitians of Canada website. Look under Eat Well, and you will find it there. And you can do many variations on
Look at this. So simple to make for the family. A side dish, a nice salad for the summertime if you don't want anything heavy in your stomach.
Yes.
And Mother's Day coming up. What a great dish to make.
What a great dish to make. And you can even put it on top of lettuce.
Oh.
As you're finishing it up using leftovers tomorrow for lunch.
Fantastic. Mm-hmm. Mary, thank you so much.
Thank you,
Appreciate
Rita.
You coming in
it's
and
a
sharing
pleasure.
The great fruits and vegetables available all across Canada and what we're all eating and some of our favorites. And again, for more information, you can check out their website. Mary, thank you.